To well, the We Hate Star Wars
Welcome
show.
Back to Star Wars. I hate Star Wars, everybody.
Oh, man.
In celebration of the Mandalorian, we're playing some more Star Wars games.
We haven't played enough Star Wars.
We haven't played enough Star Wars games yet. Or talked about it at nauseam.
I haven't watched any of the Mandalorian season 2.
Yeah, I haven't seen the next season.
We're waiting till it's all out.
But I'm just tired. I'm tired of them just throwing in characters left and right from other things. Because it's like
you haven't even seen it. We're already tired.
Yeah, like I'm just like
just the concept of it.
Yeah, it's just like yeah, I've seen them. They were in Star Wars.
Hey, you seen Boba Fett before?
You promised me a new series about new characters that was separate from other stuff. And then you're just throwing in a bunch of shit. From, like, oh, Boba Fett, he's back, he's alive! It's like, I don't, what? Why?
Yeah, right, yeah, I forgot about that he died.
Yeah.
And this takes place after he died.
Yeah, he's fucking dead. And then they bring him back just to so that they could bring him back. And it's like, you already have a Mandalorian on the show.
Yeah, you're...
The main character is a Mandalorian, man.
Have a Boba Fett.
He's a bounty hunter Mandalorian. Why do you need two? You already got one.
Oh, man. Coming out this episode swinging.
And they want to put Ahsoka in?
Yeah.
The fucking worst character from the Clone Wars?
I don't think she's the worst.
She's not the worst character. That's a bit of,
there's
a bit of a hyperbole.
Isn't Jar Jar in some episodes?
Yeah, okay. She's the worst new character, maybe. I don't know.
Ooh.
What about
Cad Bane?
Okay. She's a completely useless character.
What about Savage Opress?
Okay.
Darth Maul's secret brother. You're telling me Ahsoka's worse than...
No, okay. You know what? You're right. She's just useless. She's just like, why are you here? Why is this character here? What is your purpose? Because it's a kid show. We need to have a kid so that kids can relate.
Yeah. I guess that's what that is.
I think that's what it is.
Huh.
It's like a self-insert. It's like, you could be Anakin Skywalker's apprentice.
You could be Anakin's best friend.
You could be Anakin's best friend, the child murderer. You could be the child murderer's best friend.
You could be the Padawan's Padawan.
Okay.
Oh,
I'm not even playing.
What? We had it set up. Okay.
Did we go, because we left all the, like, menu options? We were trying to figure out the subtitle, how to get subtitles.
Yeah, and I don't think it's on the PS2 version. It might be the Xbox version.
Yeah.
Why would they do that? Why would they make it with the PS2 not have the subtitles? It doesn't make any sense at all. What are you doing, LucasArts? No wonder you crashed and burned.
Yeah, get your shit together.
Okay, we'll be back.
Come on, George.
What are you thinking, George?
We'll be right back.
No, that's fine. You're good.
You should have put those subtitles in yourself.
You're not going to pay anyone to do it.
No.
You think he knows anything about this game?
Start.
Probably not.
Do I have to press start?
Just start.
Okay, so maybe it's my...
Yeah, problem. I mean, he had to approve it, but he's probably just like, all right, yeah, that sounds fine. Will it make money? It's going to make lots. And he's like, okay, go for it.
You heard of Call of Duty? It's like that, but with Star Wars.
But with Star Wars. All right. Oh, yeah, I've heard of that. My grandchildren really like it.
Does he have grandchildren?
I don't know.
I know he has kids.
He does have kids, so.
Did he adopt kids at one point? Am I making that up?
He might have. He definitely had a chit, like a chit.
A chit. He had you're trying to say a child?
Yeah. Like, I tried to say a child and kid at the same time, and it became chit. He had a kid with his first wife.
Right.
Who was also, I think, an editor. Like, I think she co-edited, like, one of the
Star...
Like,
is she the one who saved Star Wars from being a complete mess?
Like I think she hope. She might have edited like American Graffiti or something.
Okay.
Anyway, yeah, so he had a kid with her.
Right.
But yeah, I don't know if... he has more kids, I think, also. Because I know some of them are in the prequels.
Is this... Wait, how should...
Oh, it's,
Well, the frame rate is...
Is it R1?
Oh. You can change the controls if you want.
I'll just learn
them. Okay, R1...
R1 is shoot?
Is shoot.
Okay.
I changed my controls to R2.
That's fine. I'll adapt.
Okay.
I'm not very good at this game anyway, so it's not gonna... I think I almost fell off the map.
Ooh. I'm dead.
A bit of a frame.
Yeah, so we'd be dropping frames.
Anyway, back to Mandalorian.
Back to Mandalorian.
I'm tired of fucking Disney shit where they're like, let's Marvelize Star Wars and just have everything connect to everything else. It's like, come on.
Yeah.
Can't you just make a new thing?
No.
We're making a Boba Fett show.
Yeah. Is that real? I guess
he's that. Yeah, he's in it.
I know he's in it, but
I've seen shots of him, like of what's his face, that. Yeah, like in the show, like he's in it.
Crikey, I'm here in the show to be Boba Fett.
I mean, maybe it's fine.
Oh,
maybe the new episodes are fine or whatever. But just like, it just makes me not want to watch it.
Like, yeah.
Do I need to know about Boba Fett as a character and what he's been doing? I don't care.
Yeah, is there gonna be a whole episode where he's like, I bet you're wondering how it got out
Boba
of the,
Fett was famous
out of the Sarlacc.
Purely for looking cool. Yeah. That's it.
Yeah, that's the best thing about Boba Fett is he just looks cool and he's just like,
I guess they're
there.
They're like, we want to do with Boba Fett what we did with Darth Maul. Maybe that's what they're like. Ooh. Like what's it, Dave Filoni?
It's always Dave Filoni nonsense.
I don't care. I really don't care. Like,
well, again, the thing about Darth Maul is it. I think it works fine if you don't consider Clone Wars canon.
Yeah.
The problem comes with the last season where they're like, and then it connects to Episode 3.
Yeah,
it's
right.
Like, I'm sorry, what?
How does any of this connect
to Episode
3? Exactly.
The whole premise of the show was, who cares about the canon?
Yeah.
And then they're like, yeah, and then it connects. It's like, what? What are you talking about?
Yeah, they kind of like, just, like, in Episode 3 anyway, they sort of just imply that, like, Anakin and Count Dooku, like, haven't met since Attack of the Clones.
Yeah.
Where he's like, yeah, like, I've gotten way stronger since last time.
Yeah, last time.
And then
time,
he fucking kills
meaning
him.
Meaning the time when he cut off his arm.
Yeah.
From Episode 2.
Yeah. But then in the show, they fight like 1,000 times.
Yeah, they meet all the time.
So, you're saying that his skill level has doubled since five minutes ago when they met? Yeah, it's like, the Clone Wars doesn't work.
If you consider it...
If you try to fit it together with the movie.
If you try to fit it with the other stuff.
It doesn't work.
Which is why I don't. I just pretend it's a different thing. But then, like, you don't let it go by...
Do you want to play as Keanu Wundi?
Nah. I'm not going to do any better.
My favorite character,
Kid Ed Mundi. Well, like, okay, here's what's... You know what's great about Kid Ed Mundi?
He's got a weird head,
and that's it. There's nothing more to him. Yeah. There's no fucking backstory or anything.
Yeah, no, he's just sort of there.
He's just one of the Jedis, he's a weird alien.
Yeah.
He gets shot during this mission that we're doing.
Yeah.
He gets killed by the clones. That shot where they're running and it zooms down to their feet and they stop running.
They stop.
It's actually
kind of
cool.
It's actually kind of a neat shot.
Yeah, Cad Mundi in this game, he can do like a bunch of flips.
Isn't Ventress in this game?
She's in the DLC, which is I don't think was released for the PS2.
They have DLCs for this game?
Yeah.
I don't think DLCs existed until 2009.
Was that the first account?
No, they definitely had expansion packs and stuff like years before that.
Oh yeah, like Morrowind and DLC.
Yeah, I don't know. It's just on consoles.
Right.
DLCs and expansions were different, I guess. Because you buy, like, extra discs.
Right, right.
Halo 2 had, like, a separate disc for the multiplayer. Which I guess
you'd install.
I guess
onto the system, and then I don't exactly know how they work because.
Yeah, how do you use disc if disc is what's powering the game? How can you put another disc?
Put another disc in. Because I don't know, can you install games on the original Xbox, like onto the hard drive?
I don't think so.
Because with PC it makes sense, because you could just install the whatever expansion into the, like, you could put the game into the game file, I mean, or whatever.
Maybe back when the Xbox servers were
right.
working and you had an internet connection, maybe.
I never bought expansions for games when I was in the back.
Yeah, I didn't either, because I played mostly Nintendo stuff.
Yeah.
And they didn't do fucking expansions to the Wii U, pretty much.
Wasn't really till the PS3, Xbox era, or Xbox 360 era, where DLC. I used DLC.
Mm-hmm. Although, I did play Warcraft 3, The Frozen Throne. Which is the expansion.
Oh, that's the expansion.
Warcraft 3.
Okay.
And it's pretty good.
Shit.
I just played part one of the expansion for Doom Eternal.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty fun.
It's good.
Yeah, it's
hard,
it's
right?
brutally hard. Yeah. I barely made it through. But I did it. Because the game's like, hey, you really suck at this game.
Want to change it?
You should play with the super armor heals, that makes you take no damage, basically. And
it's a really hard game.
It is really hard.
Which is fine, because, like...
Yeah, you can have hard games.
I don't know, it's like a skill-based game, mm-hmm. so you can get better at it.
Yeah
and the game, and it's, like... fun.
It's also a fun game.
Yeah, like when I mean, when it's not like really frustrating.
Yeah,
it feels good to play.
Yeah, it feels good to play. You know, I'm not even good at shooters, and I play a little bit of it, and I had a good time.
Yeah. It's the only frustrating game that I enjoy.
Right.
When I'm not frustrated with it.
But I mean, most of the time, it's pretty. I mean, it's not cheap. I guess it's like it's hard. It's brutally hard. But
oh
it's not,
yeah.
It's not insurmountable or, like, unfair, I guess.
Except for the Marauders.
Except for the Marauders, which are very hard.
Designed to be
which are designed hard. To be the most frustrating thing. And then you fight two of them in the expansion.
Are we just fighting guys, or is that...
We gotta capture the thing.
The post?
The Holocron.
Oh, the Sith Holocron?
The Sith Holocron.
From Rise of Skywalker?
Yeah.
Did I get it?
Yeah, then you gotta take it back to the gunship.
Oh, and that's the
arrow. Level.
I know.
We got two reinforcements left.
Oh, are we gonna lose?
Yeah, we might lose. I'm gonna try to get us over there.
Because I know, like, before we lose. What was it? Doom 2? I've heard it's, like, cheap hard.
Oh, yes.
Right.
Yeah. Where it's like, oh, we'll just throw 1,000 enemies at you.
I'm right there.
But not give you.
I got your back. I'll
way
shoot
to
you if anyone tries.
I did it.
Hey.
A plausible way to defeat them without.
I think we made it with one reinforcement.
Without breaking the game or whatever.
We did it.
Nice.
Well, you know, like Doom Eternal, it gives you all kinds of options to take out enemies and stuff.
Yeah.
Because it's more vertical. And you got tons of weapons, and certain enemies are weak to different kinds of weapons. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's almost, there's actually more strategy kind of going on. Do we play the part where we shoot Kid Ed Mundy? Is that a part of this level?
I think that comes later.
Oh, that comes, okay.
Can we come back to this?
Yeah. You got more kills than me.
I did?
Yeah. You died more, though.
That sounds accurate. Yeah. The
dying
part.
And you
part
got Bantha fodder as well.
Does that mean?
It means, like, cannon fodder.
Oh, yeah, so I just died a lot?
You died a lot. But you also got survivalists.
I did?
Yeah. And killing spree.
Okay. What are those?
Like little awards. Like.
Oh.
Oh, like how well you did and stuff.
Like how well you did.
But you still did better than me. Because you didn't die as much, probably?
I didn't die as much. I think I did.
More of the actual goals.
Yeah,
that makes sense. I was just trying my best to not get killed.
Yeah.
fair.
So what we're playing the story mode of.
We haven't even discussed the game yet. Yeah.
Well,
you play through all the movies from the perspective of the clone. Yeah, that's basically it.
Should we save?
There we go.
Sure.
There we've talked about the game.
Back to complaining about Mandalorian.
Back to complaining about the Mandalorian.
Okay, I have a complaint.
All right.
So okay, if I don't know, if I haven't seen any of it yet, but if and I don't remember if Ahsoka coming in the show was like a real thing, or if it was like just like a rumor, because there was like a bunch of rumors.
Right.
About, like, this guy's cast, and also this guy, and also, what's her name from Battlestar Galactica, and, like, all this stuff.
Yeah.
So, but if... nice. But if Ahsoka is in the show, that's dumb. Because wouldn't the show just end if she showed up?
Yeah. Well, she just went.
Because the whole thing is that he's protecting this baby Jedi, this baby Yoda... Oh, I also have to hit save?
Yeah.
Do I have to type it in also?
No. Okay. Good.
Right? But then if a Jedi shows up and, like, meets him...
Yeah.
Like, that's the end of the story.
Right.
Because then the Jedi, Ahsoka, couldn't take care of Baby Yoda and train him or whatever.
Yeah.
The end. Roll the credits. The story's done.
Yeah.
So, like, why would you bring in Ahsoka? unless it's the end of the... Unless because they're only doing two seasons, which I don't think
is... Dave Filoni is a genius. Goal. Or whatever.
Okay. Because otherwise, it's just you could just have endless adventures with... That's all I want! I just want him to... His one main goal is to protect this Baby Yoda thing, and he just goes on space adventures.
Yeah.
Endlessly. I'm fine with that. Do 10 seasons. Of just different space adventures.
Yeah.
Don't tie it into any...
But Dave Filoni wants to bring in all his great original characters.
Boo, fuck you. Fuck off, Dave Filoni.
That everyone loves.
Unless Dave Filoni is spelled George Lucas, you don't get to the authority to do that.
So I think we're doing the Battle of Coruscant.
Oh, okay. So now we're at the start of episode 3. Is this the same people? Were the same clones?
Yeah, the 501st Legion.
The 501st Legion.
Yeah.
The ones from the part where we kill all the Jedi. That's a level, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Don't worry. We'll get there.
Yeah. Whatever.
The droids are bad. And we beat them.
They kidnapped the Chancellor somehow, and we gotta shoot him.
We gotta blow him up.
Oh, right now we're...
This is not a drill. Repeat,
this is not a drill.
Running up space.
We gotta fly into the X-Wings.
The X-Wings.
The ARC fighters or whatever?
The ARC 170 Starfleet Triangle.
Triangle?
And then
X?
Yeah, and then right stick up and down is thrust.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, well, it's a flying.
It's a flying thing, so that's fine.
Give it a pass for the flying.
Yeah.
Inverted is fine for flying, and it's not fine for everything else.
Yeah.
So I don't know why they.
Yeah, and only the.
Why developers made inverted the default for, like, 10 years. I don't know why they did that.
And I'm dead. They're bad. So then, are we trying to get to the other ship? Is that the goal?
Destroy 5 enemy fighters.
Okey-dokey.
Oh no, the landline is ringing.
Let me put down my newspaper. In the middle of my crossword puzzle.
Okay, so why do you have to press a button just to get in it, and then another button to take off?
That's a good question.
Like, obviously I'm... like, gonna fly it.
Otherwise, yeah, why would I get in it? Oh, I think you could... Well, yeah, I guess some ships have different seats. So you can pick
the seat. Is there a barrel roll button?
Circle, yeah.
Let's try spinning. That's a good trick.
That's game design for you.
And then I think for you it would be L1 is the torpedoes.
torpedoes. Well, that would make them better for me, probably.
And pilots can heal the ships or repair the ships.
Now, this is pod racing. Oh, we never played the pod racing.
Oh, yeah. It's going to come out for the Switch.
Yeah, and then I got delayed at one point. I might be out now.
Is it out now?
I don't know, because I lost track of it. So I was, like, following it. And then
it's called Star Wars Racer.
Star Wars Racer.
We keep thinking it's called Star Wars Pod Racer.
It's a bad title. It doesn't make any sense.
Star Wars Racer, colon, now this is Pod Racing.
Colon, now this is Pod Racing.
Now this is racing.
Now this
or
is
like Star Wars Episode 1 Racer or something like that.
They've Pod Racing at Malastare. Very fast, very dangerous.
See, we gotta go to Malastare, and that's... See,
let's see Malastare.
That's a Mandalorian episode I would be okay with.
Going to Malastare and betting on pod races?
Yeah, he has to do a pod race for some reason.
He has to do a pod race?
Yeah, that'd be fun.
Baby Yoda has to do a pod race?
Baby Yoda's, like, co-piloting it, and then he's gonna lose because he's not a pod racer. But then Baby Yoda uses the force to, like, cheat. That would be amazing.
When you gamble, you eventually
lose. When you gamble, my friend, eventually you lose. And sometimes that happens when I rig the
gamble. When I rig the gamble because I'm a Jedi.
I'm a Jedi.
I have superpowers.
It's cool when I do it. Yeah, I was watching the extended pod race the other day for some reason. Well, this was like months ago, but I'm just going to say it's the other day. And, like, there's a part where... It's kind of cool. There's a part where... what's his name? Saboba has, like, a flamethrower on his ship, on his pod.
Oh, yeah?
And he, like, shoots it at Anakin and stuff, and it's cool. He, like, kills a guy with it, I think. But there's this other part that's really fun where, like, one of the pods, like, crashes, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's, like, while the Tusken Raiders are, like, shooting at them.
Right.
So, like, the Tusken Raiders, like, shoot one down and then, like, crashes. And then... all these Jawas come out of a cave and they start, like, stealing parts from the pod. And then, like, the Tusken Raiders are, like, shooting at the Jawas because they're trying to get the parts as well. And it's just, like, this completely unnecessary thing that has nothing to do with the race. And I totally get why they cut it. But it's also, like, amazing. It's just, like, so goofy and fun.
Yeah.
And great.
Yeah.
I will take that stance. The pod race scene... it's kind of fun.
Yeah. I like the pod race.
It's the you know what? I'm going to take it one step further and say it's the closest thing that we've had to the cantina scene since the cantina scene.
Wow.
Because it's just like a bunch of goofy aliens and we don't know anything about them and that's the point.
Yeah, that's fair.
I mean, I guess you could argue, like, Jabba's Palace kind of has the same vibe to it.
Yeah.
Or whatever. Or, like, even the Bounty Hunters in...
In
the Death on the Star Destroyer.
Yeah.
But... not as cool. I don't think I've done anything this whole level. I've just been killed.
Gotta destroy the shield.
That's what we're trying to do now?
Yeah. Okay. If you press select,
it'll tell me what I'm supposed to do.
Okay. Penetrate their shields.
They're still coming through.
This is impossible.
They are no match for droid guys. Is there a speed up button?
Those
if you press down on the right stick, if you press down on the right stick while you're moving it forward.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, that's too wow. That's too complicated.
Oh, just go all the way around. Whoa. Just like right here. What's up?
Let's try spinning. That's a good trick.
He didn't even try spinning in the... See, okay. That seems like a perfectly fine, like, from a story perspective, like... idea of him flying the ship at the end of episode one, right?
Yeah.
Sure. So it's like we establish he's a good pilot in the pod race early on, and then he does a race thing for real later, and then he says, oh, it's just like pod racing. But like nothing he does
in the pod race, comes back, and when he's, like, flying the ship, he just kind of does it by accident.
Yeah.
And then, he just, like...
He just, like, presses some buttons and wins.
Yeah. Like, if he... There's nothing about that. He's on autopilot for most of it.
Yeah.
And then the one time he isn't, he just, like, accidentally ends up in the, like, main reactor of the bad guy ship.
Let's try going left.
Whoa! Like...
Yeah, that's the scene.
That's the... It's so stupid. It's so dumb.
It's because George Lucas doesn't know how to write for kids.
I guess so.
Can't do it. But like, how do kids
sound? If you're supposed to... if you want to show that he's, like, good at the Force...
They're like adults, but dumber.
But fucking idiots.
I'll write them that way.
If they're, like... If he's, like, trying to show that he's, like, really powerful in the Force...
Yeah.
And that's what makes him potentially dangerous, because, like... He's gonna be arrogant and all the things that they like. Fear, you're gonna do any of that shit. Then, like, show him be good at pod racing and do something specific and smart
right.
in the race that then comes back later.
Yeah.
And the in the climax of the movie.
That's because it's like a first draft or whatever. It's definitely like, it's like an early draft. Like, they definitely didn't.
Yeah. That's
George definitely.
We did it. I didn't help at all.
George,
so I apologize.
George didn't feel like doing more drafts. He's like, I'm tired of writing. I'm just gonna make the movie now.
We already started making battle droids, and I showed Steven Spielberg and everything. So
I've already committed to.
We gotta start filming.
I said I was gonna make this movie was gonna come out in 97. It's 90.
Which one of these is? Oh, okay, never
mind. Oh, what?
What was Kills?
It was the little bullseye thing.
Which, what number, like, was it the first one?
Oh, it's the first one.
The first one? Okay, yeah. I think I had four.
Okay.
Or something, which
well,
seems
I think
like
the
too many.
Technically, the first one is, like, hero points or whatever.
Oh, like how well you did overall
yeah.
or something? Okay, well then I did four overall and you did, like, 20 or something.
Yeah.
So,
yeah. I think George Lucas wanted, the first, like, Phantom Menace to come out in 97.
Didn't it?
No, it came out in 99.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Wait, they were going to make it in a year? Was that the goal?
I don't know. He just wanted... I forget where he said it, but he's like, it's coming out in 97, and then it got delayed to 99 for whatever reason. Either he
I
was,
thought it just took
It was taking too long to write the script, or or production just went over time or whatever.
Well, it takes, like, at least 3 years to make the whole
yeah.
Star Wars movie.
Yeah.
It's kind of complicated.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then it was 99, 2002, 2005.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Just like 80, 83, and 77. They came out in that order.
Yeah.